With the COVID-19 pandemic, the holidays are looking a little different this year. I spoke with two experts about how holiday traditions can evolve and change as we try and get through this winter. Joe Elliott is the clinical director at Airlie. I just wanted to start talking with you a little bit about holiday traditions. Can you speak to a little bit about why the traditions we have around the holidays are just so important to people psychologically?
Well, holiday traditions give us a sense of normalcy, especially in times that are difficult and troubled. We often depend on our memories from better times, and those are often triggered by holiday traditions. So their importance, especially in these days, can't be understated.
What might people think about if they do want to start a new tradition, you know, something that they can do this year that doesn't have any of those memories of things they'll be missing out? What are the types of things someone should think about when they're doing that?
Well, I think, what's a new tradition for one person or one family may be a cherished tradition for another family. But if it's new to you, the significance can still be there as a new tradition. Good holiday traditions are inclusive of people. They try to include people that we may not see very often. Good holiday traditions are not super complicated. They can be very simple. So I would say those are the most important aspects of it. It's just inclusive of everybody and simple in their nature.
Priya Parker wrote The Art of the Gathering and is the host of the New York Times podcast Together Apart. Yeah, so your book has a lot of really great ideas for how to gather people together and connect authentically, but we can't do most of them right now. And especially with the holidays coming up, I wanted to hear a little bit from you about what are some of the ways that kind of people can gather while still being safe?
So, you know, the biggest message in The Art of Gathering is that we tend to focus too much on form before we actually ask what the function is, what we ask what the purpose is, what we ask what the need of the gathering is. And the more obvious seeming the gathering is, whether it's Thanksgiving dinner or a wedding or a birthday party, the more likely we are to skip asking, like, what is the need that we have this year? And how can I use that my birthday party to help address it? So similarly, as it comes to holiday gatherings, to not assume that the purpose is obvious and to actually ask yourself and then the people you want to include, like, what is it that we need this year? And for different families, for different individuals within families, the answer is going to be different. So for some, it may be a sense of release or celebration or adventure. For some, it might be a sense of like more quiet and a time to relax or rejuvenate. For some, it may be a time to mourn, right? It's been a really tough year, and to actually just have a second to grieve. And those are very different needs, and they're all okay, but you can't address them if you don't know what they are.
I think a lot of people kind of feel a sense of loss if they're thinking about doing a virtual version of a normal tradition, right? Because it just feels like a pale imitation sometimes. So what are some ideas of kind of things people can think about as they create a new tradition, maybe? Take this opportunity to build something new so you're not comparing it to what it was before.
There is a designer named Aaron Lewis, and he tweeted about this early in the pandemic, and he said something like, he called it, it's like a technical term, but he called it social skeuomorphism. And what he said is, it's that feeling when you are trying to replicate online what you used to do offline and you just feel sad. and he said part of the opportunity here is to create uniquely digital moments, right? One of the, like a global pandemic, we've is not new. We've had them before, 1918, other times. What is new is these virtual tools that we have. And it, you know, it's, so let me, like, practically say you used to love making Christmas breakfast together, or, you know, or a special birthday, you know, someone has a special birthday on New Year's Day or whatever it is, and you decide you're not going to do it together. What would it look like if you chose a specific time, you know, 10 a.m. or a specific time that meant a lot, the time of that person's birth, like they're born at 9:47 a.m. So we're all going to zoom in at 9:47 a.m. and we're going to all bake their favorite, like favorite specific brand of bacon or favorite specific donut hole or, you know, fill in the blank. And we're going to kind of live stream cooking together. Do we do it forever? No, you don't need to. But maybe in the invention, you find something that actually works. Maybe not for Thanksgiving next year, but for all the other times in the year that you wouldn't think to be together, but you can.
In Focus in Carbondale, I'm Steph Whiteside.